researchers warn of severe brain damage in mild coronavirus cases. British researchers from the University College London have found that COVID-19 patients could develop neurological complications such as stroke, brain inflammation, and nerve damage. The researchers warned that the pandemic could result in a wave of brain damage among the infected, even in patients who did not exhibit severe respiratory coronavirus symptoms. Joint senior author Dr. Michael Zandi said, "We should be vigilant and look out for these complications in people who have had COVID-19. He explained that it is still unclear if we will see an epidemic on a large scale of brain damage linked to the pandemic, and the disease's neurological effects may be understood only through follow-up studies. The study, which involved 43 patients at University College London hospitals, was published in Brain, a peer-reviewed scientific journal of neurology. The researchers studied both confirmed and suspected coronavirus patients aged 16 to 85 from April to May. Of the 43 patients who exhibited symptoms ranging from mild to severe, the doctors recorded 12 with brain inflammation, 10 with temporary brain dysfunction, 8 with strokes, and another 8 with nerve damage. According to CNN, most of the 12 patients with brain inflammation were diagnosed with acute disseminated encephalomyelitis or ADEM. ADEM occurs when the brain and spinal cord experience brief but widespread inflammation, damaging myelin, the insulating layer around the nerves. The researchers said this potentially fatal but rare disease would be recorded only around once a month before the pandemic, but they recorded at least one a week during the study. According to The Guardian, the study described a 50-year-old female patient exhibiting odd behavior after being discharged from the hospital, hallucinating monkeys and lions in her house, and repeatedly taking her coat on and off. Though she had no history of psychiatric illness, her condition improved after she took antipsychotic medication back in the hospital. Zandi said, "We want clinicians around the world to be alert to these complications of coronavirus." He called on physicians and other healthcare workers who have patients exhibiting similar symptoms to consult neurologists about these cases because the brain does appear to be involved in this illness. After the Spanish flu, up to 1 million patients seem to have developed brain disease. What Zandi fears is that some coronavirus patients may be left with subtle brain damage that is only detected years after the pandemic.